In this lesson, I will show you how to build the home of your app.
The home is the first screen people see when they access your app. Let's start with different examples of homes displayed on several screen sizes. The home is composed by elements that will display content in the first screen. This content can be pulled out from your sections, or it can be also links to several parts of your app. So you can compose the home the way you want, displaying the information you want that people will see when they first enter your app. You build your home by using widgets. You have access to 66 widgets. Each widget is customizable and has a definite function. The way the widget is displayed depends on the screen size in order to deliver the best user experience all the time. To access the customization of your home, go to the Builder menu. Inside the Builder menu, you will find four sections, and Home is the first one. Home is divided by two big elements: the header with the navbar and the body composed with widgets. Let's have a closer look at this home. It's composed by five widgets, and we can see them here in the preview. Let's add a new widget between position 1 and position 2. I click the green plus. I choose the type of my widget. Let's use a content widget. Now I decide what will be the content source of this widget. Let's choose my video section. My widget is added. Let's start the customization. Customization is done by editing the widget. What you can do first is choosing a template to display your content. There are several templates per widget. Look for the one you like, and when you're happy with the result, go back to the Settings tab to continue the customization. My widget is composed by several elements. In the header, I can decide to display the title of the widget or not. When displayed, you access to several design options. The content zone is the place where the content is displayed inside a widget. Here, you have access to a wide range of design options. When you see those two logos, it means that the option you're customizing will be only visible on the related screen size. So in this example, it will be visible on tablet and on the desktop. If I switch to the mobile view of my widget, you see that there is no play button in this view. To modify the way the content is retrieved from the section, go to the option for the content zone. You can choose the sorting option for the content, you can add meta information using tokens, and you can decide of the number of items that will be displayed inside the widget. The General Settings tab will give you extra options to apply at the general level of the widget. I moved my widget to the position number 6 using the drag and drop option, and I turned it off because I don't want it to be displayed on the home. Now I'm going to add another widget at the bottom of my home, and I will use a link widget. Links widgets are used to build the navigation inside your home. So here, when I edit my widget, the first thing I need to do is to add the destination of my widget. It can be a section, or if I add another link, it can be also a call to action. Here is a third example with an external link as the destination. The design options of your widget will depend on the template you choose. Several templates are available. We are going to customize the grid. In this template, I can choose an icon for my links. I can provide a title for each link and provide the required information for the destination. Once the information are provided, I can work on my design. From the general settings, I will change the background of my widget, the title color, and the icon color. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time, and meanwhile, happy app building.